Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to TechnoGenie. In this lecture, we will study sag and tension analysis in a transmission line. If you see these two diagrams, we have multiple towers connected with the and the conductor is connected with these towers. So the distance between one tower and the other tower is span, and this parabolic formation of the conductor is known as sag. And the weight of the conductor is acting on the cross arm of the tower, and this weight effect is known as tension of the tower. So with the change in temperature, the conductor may contract or relax. In the summer, when the temperature increases, the conductor expand, and in the winter, when temperature is reduced, the conductor contracts. So these expansion and contraction affect the value of the sag. If we do not create any sag, then there is a chance of the conductor to be break during the contraction or relaxation process. So in this lecture, we will study introduction of the sag and tension, effect of change in temperature, line sag and tension calculation, effect of ice and wind loading, and some mechanical structure principles. So introduction. Conductor sag and tension analysis is an important consideration in overhead distribution line design as well as overhead transmission line. You must consider in mind that during the distribution, the sag does not create any difference because the difference between one tower and the other tower is very small. But in overhead high voltage transmission line, the sag is usually very important factor because the distance between one tower and two and the second tower is very high. So we need to do something about the sag. Thus, the design engineer must determine in advance the amount of the sag and the tension to be given to the wire or the cable of a particular line at a given temperature. So we have multiple softwares. In that softwares, when we define the distance between one tower and another tower, and we know the weight of the conductor, then after implementing these values in the software, we will find the appropriate value of the sag. And there are many mathematical formulas based on which we can calculate sag. So in order to specify the tension to be used in the string, the line conductor, the value of the sag and the tension for the winter and the summer condition must be known. Secondly, there are some factors which affect the sag. The major factors which affect the sag is the length of the conductor, span or the distance between one tower and the other tower. Third is the temperature. As you know that with the increase in the temperature or the decrease in the temperature, the length of the conductor changes, and this change in the temperature affect the sag value. And fourth one is the conductor tension. In order to determine the conductor load properly, the factor that need to be taken in account is the weight of the conductor, weight of the ice or snow clinging to the wire, and wind blowing against the wire. If you see that the weight of the wire is usually in vertical formation, and the weight of the snow or the wind is also in vertical formation, but the weight of the air is usually in horizontal formation. So we need to consider these three parameters while calculating tension. So sag and stress vary with temperature on account of the thermal expansion and contraction of the conductor. As I already told you that with the increase in the temperature, the length of the conductor increases, thus it increases the sag. But with the decrease in the temperature, length of the conductor contracts and it decreases the value of the sag. So the maximum stress occur at the lowest temperature when the line has contracted and is also possibly covered with ice or ice and the snow. If the conductor is unstressed or the conductor stress is constant while the temperature changes, the change in length of the conductor is delta L is equal to L naught alpha delta T, where delta L is the change in length, L naught is the conductor length at the initial temperature. Alpha is the coefficient of the linear expansion of the conductor per degree Fahrenheit, and delta T is the change in the temperature. But if the temperature is constant while the conductor stress changes, the change in length of the conductor is delta L is equal to L naught delta T over MA. So when the temperature changes, the formula is this one, but when the temperature is constant but the there is some mass in the on the conductor, then the formula is this one. So L naught is basically the ideal length of the conductor at normal temperature. T naught is the conductor initial tension. Delta T is the change in the conductor tension. M is the modulus of elasticity of the conductor in pounds inch, and A is the cross-sectional area. Now, what is sag? The difference in the level between point of the spot and the lowest point on the conductor is known as sag. So if you see this diagram, so this is the top point and this is the lowest point. So this, the difference between the top point and the lowest point, is known as sag. So a conductor suspended freely from two spots which are at the same level and the spaced L unit length apart as shown in the figure takes the formation of catenary curve or parabolic formation, providing the conductor is perfectly flexible and its weight is uniformly distributed along the length. So this is the sag in the transmission line. So in the distribution system, determining accurate value of the sag is not so important as it is in the transmission system. The conductor sag should be kept to minimum in order to reduce the conductor material required to avoid extra pole height for sufficient clearance above the ground. As you know that if the sag increases, then we require a large amount of the conductor, say, and that conductor will affect the cost factor or the economy of the system. So it is also desirable that the tension in the conductor should be low to avoid the mechanical failures of the conductor to permit the use of the less strong spot. So these are the two parameter, one is sag and the second one is tension. If we increase sag, tension will decrease, but if we increase tension, the sag will decrease. So they are inversely proportional to each other. So however, low conductor tension and minimum sags are not possible. It is because the low sag mean a tight wire and high tension, while a low tension mean a loose wire and increased sag. Therefore, the actual practice is a compromise between sag and the tension. So now the calculation of the sag. In an overhead transmission line, the sag should be so adjusted that the tension in the conductor is within safe limit. The tension is governed by the conductor weight, effect of the wind, ice loading, and the temperature variation. It is standard practice to keep the conductor tension less than 50% of its ultimate tensile strength. Minimum factor of the safety is respect of the conductor tension should be 2. So the tension should be less than 50%. We shall now calculate sag and tension of the conductor. There are two different cases in order to calculate the sag of the conductor. One is when the tower height is same, or second one is when the tower height is unequal in the mountain areas. So when the tower height is equal, that means we have two points. This is A and this is B. So this A and B is basically the top end of the tower, and this is the wire, and the distance between the top end and the bottom end is known as sag. So now we will calculate different parameters of the sag, but we need to consider that the in between A and B there is a common point which is known as O. And if we consider another point P, then the difference between the O and P is X, and half of O and P is X by 2. So L is the length of the span, W is the weight per unit length of the span, and T is the tension of the span. Considering a point P on the conductor, taking the lowest point O on as the origin, let the coordinates of P be X and Y. So if you see, this is P. So the coordinate of P along X-axis is X and the coordinate of P along Y-axis is Y. So the weight WX of the conductor act at the distance X by 2 from O. So this is the weight. So the weight is the W into X by 2. And the tension T acting at 0. So at O point, tension is occurring. So if we mathematically define the momentum of these two mathematical equations, then the and equating these two mechanical equations, we have T Y is equal to W X into X by 2. So when we simplify it, it is Y is equal to W X squared divided by 2 T. So that the maximum dip or the sag is represented by the value of Y at either of the support of A and B. So X is half of the length and Y is the sag. So the sag would be W into length by 2 square divided by 2 T, which is W L square over 8 T. So this is the value of the sag when the tower height is same. But if the tower height is not the same or unequal in some mountain area, then there are two sag. One is from B to O and second one is from A to O. So we need to calculate S1 and S2. While if the center point is O or the lowest point is O, then the distance between A and O is X1 and the distance between B and O is X2. T is the tension in the conductor, H is the difference in level between the two supports, and L is the span length. So if you see, this is H, this is S2, and this is S1. So if W is the weight per unit length of the conductor, then S1 is equal to W X1 square over 2T, and S2 is equal to W X2 square over 2T. So this is the same formula which we calculate over here, but we change the value of L into X. So the second thing is that sum of X1 and X2 is L. So we should keep this thing in mind. Now this is the calculation. Now we need to calculate X1 and X2. So S2 minus S1 is equal to this value when we substitute the values. And finally, we find the value of X2 minus X1, that is 2 times TH over WL. And in the previous slide, we calculate X1 plus X2 is equal to L. When we equate these equation, we will find X1 and X2. X1 is half time, half minus TH over WL, L over 2 minus TH over WL, and X2 is L over 2 plus TH over WL. So these are the two equations which are produced in the system when we have two different sizes of poles. So the above formula for the sag are true only in still air at normal temperature when the conductor is acting by its weight only. However, in actual practice, a conductor may have ice coating and simultaneous subject to the wind pressure. The weight of the ice act vertically down in the same direction as the weight of the conductor. So the ice and the weight of the conductor is practically down. The force due to the wind is assumed to be act as horizontal at right angle to the projected surface of the conductor. Hence, the total force on the conductor is the vector sum of horizontal and the vertical as shown in the figure. So this is the conductor. This is the conductor and this is the ice coating. So the conductor diameter of the conductor is D and the diameter of the ice coating is D. While these are the two parameters, we have W factor due to the wind and the second factor is due to the weight of the ice or snow. So the overall combined factor would be an hypotenuse. So WT is under root of V plus VI square plus VW square, and while WT is the weight of the ice per unit, and W is the wind force per unit length. So these are the four parameters which are used to calculate this one. So when the conductor has wind and ice loading, also the following point: when the conductor set itself in a plane at an angle theta to vertical, where tan theta is equal to WW, this one WW over W plus WI. So this is the angle between these things. Now S is WT L square over 2T, and vertical sag is S time cos theta. So when we calculate theta, then it is S time cos theta. These are few example to calculate the sag. The first example is a 132 kV transmission line has the following data: weight of the conductor, length of the span, ultimate strength, and safety factor. Calculate the height above ground at which the conductor should be separated. Ground clearance required is 10 meter. So weight of the conductor is 680 divided by 1000. So we can get 0.68. And working tension is T is equal to ultimate strength divided by safety factor. So the ultimate strength is 3100 divided by 2. So tension is 1550. L is 260 meters length of the span. So sag is equal to W into L square over 8T. So overall value of the sag is 3.7 meters. So the minimum distance between the conductor and the ground is required to be 10 meters. So when we add 10 plus 3.7, it is 13.7, which is the which would be the support at the height of 13.7. Second is a transmission line has a span of 15 meter between the levels. For the conductor has a cross-sectional area of 2 centimeter square, the tension in the conductor is 200 kg. If the specific gravity of the conductor material is 9.9 gram per centimeter cube and the wind pressure is 1.5 kilogram per meter line, calculate the sag. What is the vertical sag? So span is L is equal to 150 meters, working tension T is equal to 2000, wind force or length of the conductor WW is 1.5 kg, which is given over here. While weight of the conductor is specific gravity multiplied by volume. So specific gravity is 9.9 and into 2 into 100. So this is the value which we can. The total weight of 1 meter length of a conductor is W square plus W square under root, that is 1.92 square plus 1.5 square is equal to 2.48 kg, while S is equal to WT L square divided by 80. So sag is 3.48. So this is the value of the slant sag in the direction making a theta, making an angle theta with vertical references. The value of theta is given by tan theta is equal to WT over W, and theta is equal to tan inverse W over W. And vertical sag is S time cos theta. When we calculate theta, then we put the value of the theta, and overall vertical sag is 3.48 into cos 37.2. So these are the few examples. This is 8.19. Now there are some mechanical principles which we should consider in mind. Number one is the tower height. Tower height dependent on the line of span. When long span relatively few towers are required, but they must be tall and correspondingly costly. So the height of tower is very important. The second one is conductor clearance to the ground. The conductor clearance to the ground at the time of greatest sag should not be less than some specific distance, depending on the voltage, on the nature of the country, and on the level of the ground. So the conductor clearance between the ground and the first conductor is very important. The third point is sag and tension. When lying overhead transmission line, it is necessary to allow a reasonable factor of safety in respect of the tension to which the conductor is subjected. The tension is governed by effect of wind, ice loading and temperature variation. The relationship between the tension and the sag is dependent on the load condition and the temperature variation. So if you see this diagram, that with the increase in the temperature, sag increases, and with the increase in temperature, tension decreases. So there is some common point available in order to get my best value of the sag and the tension. Conductor vibration. When wind exerts pressure on the exposed surface of the conductor, if the wind velocity is small, the swing of the conductor is harmless, provided the clearance is sufficiently large so that the conductor do not approach within the sparking distance of each other. And this is the assignment. We have four different questions from the VK Mehta book, and you need to complete this assignment in just 3 to 4 days. Thank you. Jazakallah. Hopefully you will understand my lecture, and if you have some question, you can ask it in the comment section. Thank you.